Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. It's time for more Magic with Mutombo. As always, hope you guys are having an amazing day today. So we are playing this deck. It is called Johnny and Friends. This was shown to us by one of our buddies in Discord, John the Jank Master. He's given us a few other decks, but we made a few tweaks to it. Apparently this deck was originally played by another YouTuber, CGB. But I didn't like some of the cards in it. I really didn't like Dovin. I don't even remember what else we changed in it. But we did make a few changes. So let's just kind of hop into it. So a Johnny and Friends, really we're just calling it that because a Johnny's cool. He's a sweet, you know, fighting lion guy. And, you know, and we're playing a bunch of other Planeswalkers. So usually Super Friends decks are decks that have a lot of Planeswalkers in it when they're like Planeswalker centric. And you build your deck around those. So that's what we're doing. So we have four Johnnies, we have four Teferis, we have two Gideons. So that's one of the changes we made in the other deck. We dropped one Gideon, actually. There were, I believe, three. So we dropped one of those for an Elspeth. I like Elspeth's recurability. You know, once she dies after making tokens or getting you life or pumping your tokens, you can exile some cards from your graveyard to get her back. So that's kind of cool. The other creatures we're playing a Johnny's Pride Mates. Well, because we have a lot of life gain in our deck, so we want those to grow. A Johnny, the Planeswalker, also makes tokens that are called the Johnny's Pride Mate, so they do the same thing. And we have Heliod. Again, because we have a lot of life gain, we're going to be pumping, hopefully, a lot of our, you know, creatures slash Planeswalkers. You know, in order just to get in there. On top of that, we just have a lot of removal. We have four Shatter the Skies. We have four Elspeth Conquers Death. And we have added two Planar Cleansings because I feel like it could be important for us to clear off their Planeswalkers. If they have a lot of Planeswalkers, we may just need to clear more than just creatures. So, you know, if we're playing, it's like a Team of Wreck deck, we want to get rid of their enchantments. If we're playing against an adventure deck, we want to get rid of their Lucky Clovers. And then on top of that, you know, we have Helios Intervention just in case we can gain life with it against we're playing with mono red because we are playing best of one. And then we also have Birth of Melodus for early defense, life gain, and Dawn of Hope for, since we're playing a lot of life gain, it's going to let us draw cards whenever we gain life for, you know, two mana a draw. So I'm really looking forward to this deck. This is a slow, control-y type deck. So I'm sure these games are going to be kind of grindy unless people just decide to scoop after we, you know, drop a turn three Teferi like that happens sometimes. But we'll see. So we'll hop in the gameplay and we will catch you back up at the roundup and the wrap up. I'm sorry to let you know how we do. Cool. See you guys soon. All right. We're going to try out some Johnny and Friends, blue, white, mainly mono white Super Friends. Let's see. This is going to be a mulligan. And this we will keep. And we're going to put a Gideon to the bottom. I don't think we need two of those. Of course, we're playing against a red deck. So we actually tried this deck out three games before we started recording. And all three games we played against mono red. So it's kind of fitting that, of course, we just keep getting paired against mono red. So we're definitely gonna need to draw Wrath. Because why not? They hit a land. Yep, Hollowed Fountain. Okay, so really the good thing is we can reset this runaway Steamkin, but we need to draw a shatter this guy. That's priority number one. He's gonna go Steamkin into Rimrock Knight and get in. He should just get in first. He could hit something good. We don't want him to hit something good, but I mean, we're gonna block that. You have a shock? Fine if you do. So the question is, yeah, I think we're just gonna try to play down as many permanents as possible. And we're just gonna hope that he thins our deck down to the Shatter of the Sky. We're gonna end up bouncing this Annex before we Shatter, hopefully. So. Oh, that Gideon sucks. Bounce, bounce. Bounce, bounce, even another Rimrock. That only pumps power, not toughness. So, it's fine. Okay. So, the good news is, got rid of that robber, the rich. What do? He's not going to be able to play Gideon unless he has another robber. So the question is, let's go ahead and pump this up first. It's unfortunate, we're only going to get one play here. We need it to be let's go ahead and bounce the Annex. Get him to replay it. Okay, Castle Ardenvale, not the worst draw. Not the best draw. Okay. Well, that's good. He basically is spending his whole turn playing that guy. That's more like it. So do we Heliod and Gideon? One, two, three, four. That's going to utilize our mana the best, but and it's going to gain us some life. I do like this. We're going to give this indestructible. So he'll probably have to go after the Gideon. Okay, no, he's just putting as many things as he can in the way. Yep, so he is. Okay, no. I'm definitely inclined to block for the Gideon, but I really don't care about Teferi. So time for plan B. As soon as I think of one. So another mobilized district is actually pretty good. This will turn on Heliod. We are going to... Already indestructible. Lifelink is kind of irrelevant. So vigilant. Here we go. Maybe it was wrong to. The good thing is we have an additional blocker as well in the mobilized district. Oh, that sucks. That's not a good draw. For him, it's a great draw. Okay, I don't know why you... Is it a sorcery? Oh, it's an instant. And he's coming this way, so we are going to... All right, so, oh, okay, so he has a, he has a whatchamacallit. Where's his mana? Does it not show mana in between? So that's fine. I don't know what happened to his mana. He tapped it after he attacked. So, all right, well, good game. Chilan. Opponent goes first. Opponent always goes first. I think we're going to keep this. This really isn't an explosive draw by any means. This deck really isn't an explosive deck, but we have a 2-drop into a 3-drop that doesn't really do anything. Well, we have a better 3-drop now. Well, we can do that as well. So I imagine he has... Okay. I mean, unfortunately, though, I'm going to offer you up this trade. So he should have blocked there. Well, I guess he can lifelink his pride mate with his Heliod. Now he can't, though. So. All right, so that draw was huge. Just that fourth land. We might get a concession out of this. So we're going to do indestructible because we are going to Wrath. And we're going to have creatures and he's not. I'm actually very surprised that he did not wrath there. Or not wrath, but concede. Okay. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. What do we do here? So Heliod's really good. So we're gonna give this indestructible and lifelink. And we're gonna get in. So any permanent he's going to play other than land should turn on his Heliod. He's got four devotion. That's a pretty good one. So I don't know why he attacked with both. He could have just swung with one of them. Two. One, two, three. All right, so that's going to turn that on. You're going to gain life. We are going to plus here. He's got to block at least one of these. It's going to turn off his Heliod. So he may double block. So, I really, really wish we could kill the both of these. I think we have to kill the bigger one. So again, any permanent's going to turn on Heliod. Unfortunate. So really the only plus here is that we do have a planar cleansing. He has no cards in his hand. That's an enchantment. All right, so let's start this game over. And so he has enough to start making guys there. Do we want to just get in for... All right, so we're going to play both of these. Get our last planes. Dawn of Hope. All right, so we have a slight advantage because we can make more 1/1s a turn than he can. And our 1/1s are going to have lifelink. Yep. I'm gonna let you have it. So the good thing is now is when we swing in here, he may block, but we're gonna be able to put another token into play, and we're gonna be able to pump the other token. So, okay. And yeah, we'll pay. So yeah, so now he's gonna have to hold back. He's gonna have to double block our token. But unfortunately for him, we gain some life. We have a 3/3. We will auto pay, and we will decline. So let's go ahead and gain even some more life here. Okay. Do it to it, buddy. We are going to decline. We are going to decline. That was a good draw. I bet you're blocking that 6/6. Okay. So he should give his guy lifelink. It's not going to really do anything other than pump his Heliod, but it will gain him one life. So one life is, you know, nothing really to shy at. Any kind of benefit that you can, you know, give yourself, any edge. But I mean, we really need him to do something here. Rope and rope and rope and rope and ha. Come on, dude. We could both easily be in the next game. But instead, for some reason, you want a rope. All right, well. You know you've won when your opponent is a sore loser and ropes you. So. They will eventually start punishing people for roping, you know, for no reason. This guy has one action that he has available to him. So we'll give him the old nice. And I bet he's going to just end up conceding after all of his ropes are gone. That's just how people do it nowadays. It's unfortunate. But now you don't. Now you won't get the benefit of that one life because you gave up all of your actions. So. Yep, we're gonna pump. We're gonna auto pay. Cool. And now we wait for Senor Ropefest. So. So just want, you know, just want you guys to see this is what people do when they are sore losers. And again, you know, I've hit on this before in some of my other videos. This doesn't really benefit him. It doesn't really benefit me. You know, I know it's a part of the game. You know, I go into the games expecting that this could potentially happen. And it really just hurts him more because he could be, if he liked Magic, I mean, he could just be, he could have conceded. He could be playing another game. We could both be in another game. So for people who do this, this just isn't your game. Like, don't play Magic. So. Good game, dude. It's time. Let's do it. Let's play some a Johnny and Friends some more. All right, pretty quick, pretty quick. Macaroni Attack-oni. All right. What a weirdly stupid name. It did get a chuckle out of me, so. Do any of these break? I know sometimes when you click on. Really nothing? Nothing? Well, Macaroni. Time for you to hop on into this game. Hop on into this game, yeah. We're gonna keep this. Seems like an okay hand. Always expect the turn one mountain. Ooh, not a turn one mountain. All right. What are we on for? Yeah, we can keep an Ajani. Ajani's pride mate, to be specific. Oh no. Bye, Heliod. It's definitely gonna be one of my creatures slash planeswalkers. I imagine it's Heliod. It's usually always Heliod. And we'll go ahead and play the Pride Maid. I know it may not be the best play on turn two here. Yeah. That's why. So we're playing a good old Doom Foretold deck. Probably the Dawn of Hope goes. Elspeth comes back, so I don't really know why he would take Elspeth. You just made it cost 6 instead of 4. Oh, exile the graveyard. Well. Forgot about chapter 3. Never forget about chapter 3, guys. So Doom Foretold doesn't really do much here. Okay. So, yeah, I think we're gonna pay. So Doom Foretold here, though, however, is gonna be a different story because it will kill our Dawn of Hope. We should probably. Oh no, not there. Let me put it on my side. He has a lot of permanents to sack over there. Oh, okay. Cavalier. Fine. Go and draw. Go and get rid of you. I mean, we're not going to attack. It's kind of irrelevant to do that. But we will just go ahead and get a land so our turn ends. Alright, so he goes back up to 20. I gain 2 life for each of the Birth of Meletus. Okay, so Castle Ardenvale's pretty decent draw. Nothing we can get back. So he can start making attackers as well. It's really going to come down to who draws the first real card. I mean, I can't really think of a better way to put that. He draws another Treacherous Blessing. That'll put him pretty far ahead. Johnny's not the worst draw. I don't think we make any. That's fine. No attacks. I mean, if he can empty his hand pretty quickly in the next, like, 2 turns, him drawing with the, with his castle Loctwain, that's, so I can't make a guy, I'm 1 land short. He, however, is not. So. I mean, we're gonna have to get him to do something here. I'd really like him to pay 6 life and draw a card. Another rider? Yep. Final payment, that's fine. The same thing. Removal. So he might be consider playing another Cavalier of Dawn, killing one of his tokens. You probably want to kill a wall, not a 1/1. Let's see it. Can do it now. Kill that 3-3. Yep. So, do you want me to phase you out of time? Yeah, that's fine. Might be a bad idea. I don't think this is gonna turn out how you want it to. So you can definitely Wrath here. It's not going to be a big deal. You're going to kill a land. Okay. All right, here come the card draws. He needs to deal with Heliod. Pretty good draw. How many cards you got? 8. For sure. And a Doom Foretold. Okay. Well, it looks like... looks like we're going to be Planar Cleansing. Let's go ahead and get rid of Teferi. We won't have enough. Man. It's non-land permanence, right? Go and do it to it. Ooh, that's not good. That is not good for us, team. So he... yeah, he has enough to make two guys a turn. I honestly don't even feel like I would bother with that. Oh, excuse me. Oh, well, we're just living the dream now, huh? Okay. I have a feeling he has another Doom Foretold, which will probably wrap up the game. Oh yeah, Treacherous Blessing. There's no way he doesn't draw another. Doom Foretold incoming. We've both drawn a lot of land this game. I'm gonna take it. You gotta target your Treacherous Blessing and then not get a 3-3? Yep. Oops. I don't want to cast that at all. All right, well, next game. What is in store for us now? All right, what do we got? Turn three Heliod is really not a good way to start. This is a horrible hand. We have to keep it, though. We can't cast any of the cards in our hand. Okay, well, we can cast one card in our hand now. So we're just going to play against a lot of Doom Foretold, Dance of the Mance decks. I do have a feeling that's what we're playing against. Here comes the Thought Erasure. And all the temples. Thank me later. Enough. Here we go. Go ahead and... Yep. I mean, we all knew that was coming. I mean, for how slow Gideon is, his minus six should be exile any permanent. What? Why would you quit there? Okay. I don't really understand why people do that. Never gonna understand that. Let me finish this water. Toss this into the trash over here. Nailed it. What's up, Persephone? Huh? 30 seconds. We're at 30 seconds for matchmaking. Nikki Pole. Pono goes first, like always. We're going to temple into district, into birth, into... maybe we don't play. Maybe we play Interplanar Beacon second. All right, we're going to keep. Probably play against, yep. No. Yep. Teamer Clover. He knows about the planes, guys. He knows. I have a feeling. No, just the Clover. All right. Good thing is, though. I mean, he can... I'm known for my excellent timing. You can recast. Do we... Hold on. Yeah, I still think that's the right decision. He can play a land, play another Lucky Clover, double stomp our wall, attack Teferi for one. And then I'm still fine with that. Oh no, he's just stuck. Stuck on them lands. So yeah, we're gonna plus just because we don't want him to double stomp here and kill a Johnny. Okay. So he was still stuck on land. I really did contemplate playing out another Teferi and bouncing the lucky clover. He definitely has a stomp. He probably gets another forest here. He only has one green source. Okay, another one in his hand. Okay, he's doing it to it. So he could bounce both of our planeswalkers, which is fine. Or he could he's gonna bounce. If he has a Brazen Bar, he's gonna bounce a wall and a Johnny. And then swing in at Teferi for one. Yep. Crazy, it's like I played against this deck before. No, I am not making this up as I go. Do this. I feel like we're still gonna go for life. I feel the Ajani minus zero might come into play this game. Okay. Okay. And now he starts playing the creatures. If he doesn't, we're gonna Wrath. Okay, we're gonna Wrath. He'll play one creature. He'll probably play the Lovestruck Beast. Maybe he doesn't have any more basics. No, unfortunate. I would like for him to actually play. He has another Brazen Bar. Wow. Pretty amazing. So, I think we have to play a... Got to keep him off this card advantage, so. I'm imagining he's going to probably use his Granzid. Yep. Probably get the, put an enchantment on the bottom of its owner's library card. Or... Oh, okay. Fine. I don't know why you're playing one of those in your sideboard. Oh, and a negate. Okay. Pretty good. I mean, I have Teferi, though. 6. So everything else is does kill artifacts? Yep, it sure does. Decline, climb. You show remorse, I'll show you.
I'm proud of all those who stand up to me. Let's get rid of those.
And let's yep. I still feel like we're pretty far behind. He has a lot of mana, but he's not copying anything, which is okay. Okay, so you're bouncing. You don't know that I have another one, so you have to save two blue. You're not even going to. Decline. Do I want to draw one? Yeah, I'm going to draw one card. Oh, there you go. What do you get? I imagine Chandra is still like the card he should be getting. You're getting cards that you can't do anything with. Like, oh, cancel. Indestructible. Can give life link. Make you bigger, we'll decline. I believe in you. You have so many cards. So many cards. That's why this deck is really good. Just every card is feeling another interaction somewhere else. I'm imagining this is going to get negated. Line. So we could do this, bounce the 18-18. Bounce that. And do we have lethal? He has to block, like 100% has to block. 10. All right. Gideon is really good. That's fine. I mean, he's going to have to throw down as many blockers as possible, but unfortunately, Brazen Borrower doesn't block. Might want to be throwing down your Lovestruck Beasts instead. He might be bouncing that. Looks like he is. Are you out of land? He's still not out of land. Wow, you play a lot of basics in that deck. Okay. Beanstalk Giant, maybe? No, okay. Lovestruck Beast. Draw a card. I really need him to tap out. This is a close game. I mean, I know we're at 50, and that kind of sounds ridiculous, but this is a close game. I mean, he could easily win. Okay. So... is going after Gideon. That definitely wins us a game. Pay two life. Indestructible. 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 Good game. We got there. All right, guys, let's go over what our results were. So we managed to go 4-1 with this with the deck. We lost to a black white Doom Foretold deck. I'm not really surprised by that. One Doom Foretold that just lands and sticks can really deal a lot of damage. That's not, you know, that's just the unfortunate reality of this. But however, the other games that we played were awesome. We beat Teamer Adventure. That's a really hard deck to beat, especially with the insane amount of cards that they were drawing and going off with. Really happy with how this deck turned out. So, and I do apologize for how long and grindy the games are. I was right, in my assumption at the beginning that these games probably would be long and grindy because this is a control type deck. Now, changes that I would make, I think I would take out the Heliod's Intervention. I don't really feel like we got a chance to really experiment with it. Again, it could be decent in a, in a mono red against the mono red deck. But I do feel like we might want to up the Gideon back up to 3. I was really impressed with Elspeth being able to cast Elspeth, over and over again. Heliod was really good. We didn't really draw Elspeth's Conqueror's Deaths a lot. It's one of my favorite cards in Standard right now. But, I mean, really didn't come into play, I don't feel like, that often. And the Tranquil Coves, those really aren't that good, I don't feel like. I understand that they're very synergistic with the Ajani Pride Mates and, the Dawn of Hope, the life gain triggers and whatnot. But I just really don't like having to rely on that many come into play tap lands. So I feel like we should just bump up the Fable Passage count more, maybe throw in a couple of more islands, maybe just go up to 2 or 3 islands. Or if we decide to actually stick with the tap land, I feel like they should just be Temple of Enlightenments. So I really don't feel like that gain 1 life is really that important in this deck. But yeah, overall, I hope you guys enjoy the game. And, you know, I did leave one game in where the guy roped us, and I just wanted you to kind of experience that. I know some people haven't experienced that because they're super lucky, but, you know, that's just part of the reality. You know, guys, it's at the end of the game, you know, at the end of the day, you know, everybody just needs to realize it's a game. You can't win every game. And when you've identified that you can't win a game, I feel like it's just best to, you know, to make sure that you haven't exhausted all of your resources. You know, take a turn to think, but then at the same time, just move on to the next game so both of you guys can have fun. And if you're just going to rope every time somebody beats you, then, you know, Magic's not the game for you, or Magic Arena is not the game for you. And maybe just games in general just, you know, aren't for you, you know, because games are meant to, you know, be fun. And yeah, you know, it is frustrating sometimes when you lose, but, you know, again, just move on to the next game, go take a breather, go do some jumping jacks, take a walk, you know, just calm your mind and just move on to the next one. So with that being said, guys, I appreciate you guys coming back as always. Please, if you haven't, hit like, subscribe. Please leave a comment. Please let me know what you want me to play in the next deck. Leave a comment in, with your deck list or a link to your deck list. And yeah, so I'd really appreciate that. And then again, we're going to hit on the Hunter Burton Memorial Open Tournament. It's a charity event to help spread awareness for suicide prevention, and HunterBurtonMemorialOpen.com. You can get all the details there. So I would really love to see you guys all there at the end of the month. It's the last week or the last weekend in March. And again, really appreciate you guys coming back. So we will see you guys next time.